book, no matter what that book is, whether Shakespeare is an old line, the stuff of the raised about raised falls and is juxtaposed in them, or any other written word that you digest or ingest, you have to question it because it was written by another man, another human being. And no one man has all the answers. A lot of people take the Bible face value that it's God's word, but nobody's looking in the upper left-hand corner of that page. It says the book of Timothy. Timothy was a man, so it's written by a man. Now, what is told to us is that it was under the inspiration of the heavens. God inspired them to write the book. Now let's do the definition of the word inspiration. I can inspire another young comedian to want to do comedy, but it's everything I do, the butt naked truth and the laws of the universe. As Richard Pryor inspired me to do comedy, but do I really want to follow everything he did? Because if I did, I'd set myself on fire and be smoking crack. So all of us are a dual examples. There's certain parts of Eddie Griffin that you can follow to the letter and it'll be success. Then there's other parts of my life you want to stay the hell away from. Because trust me, if you jumped in my shoes, you jumped the fuck right back out. No, nigga, I don't want to be you. You understand me? So the truth of the matter is individual. Your truth will never be my truth. There is a basic butt naked correlating truth that goes through all humanity. But then we all find our individual truth in this journey called life. Lesbians are just as important as a homosexual, as is a straight person, a man's objectivity and perception of what he brings to the table is no more important than a female's objectivity and what she brings to the table. She brings education and nurture. We bring two P's, provide and protect. That is the nature of our being. We leave our houses when we feel like we're not providing and we're not protecting because we don't feel like a man then. You just took my two nuts. One is provide, one is protect. When you make me feel like I'm not providing and I'm not protecting, I don't want to stay in the house because I'm not a man no more. A woman will leave the house when she feels like she's not educating the children and nurturing their existence. She'll get up and leave because you took that from her, which is her basic mode of operation. So what is true? Nobody knows. It's individual to the individual's experience and life. Find your truth and stop running around with a book that says it's the truth and nothing else is. Because if you truly understand the entity known as God, Jehovah, Allah, whatever name you want to stick on it, the great IT never would be that big an asshole where he wouldn't understand his entire creation will always find his individual truth. Because he gave you that right to do so. It's called choice. That's what separates us from basic animals. A lion doesn't have a choice in a decision in being a lion. It's a lion. When it's hungry, it's gonna kill, it's gonna eat. After it eat, you can lay right next to that motherfucker. It ain't gonna hurt you. Because it's taking care of its basic nature. It doesn't have a choice. An insect is going to do what it is designed to do, programmed to do. So anybody that thinks that it's not a master designer, all life has a program and how it works in the ecosystem. We're the only living entities on this planet that do not fit in the ecosystem. So if you're looking for an alien, look in the mirror. It's you. You don't fit in because you have a choice. You can manipulate your environment. Everything else is manipulated by its environment. A tree has to do photosynthesis. Otherwise, it's not a tree. We don't have to do a damn thing. There's only one thing we have to do. That's love. It is the moving force of the human race. What's the opposite of love? There's your devil. It ain't some invisible dude way down in hell running around. It's you. It's the duality of self. You have a God state, you got a devil state. Which one are you flexing? Are you flexing your God or are you flexing your devil? Sometimes the devil can be fun. Sometimes God can be boring. Sometimes God is fun. I bought my mama a house. I got my kids some clothes. Sometimes the devil get on your damn nerves. Why are you trying to shoot at me, nigga? What's wrong with you? So we have to figure out which part of our attributes are we flexing, God or the devil. That's why he said, I'm gonna make man in my image. When you look in the mirror, do you not see your image? So who's God? All of us little miniature pieces of God hanging the fuck out with each other. Imagine being God. Before the entire universe is created, imagine being all-knowing with nobody to share all this information with. What do you suffer from? Loneliness. So you blow yourself into a zillion parsecs, thus the ever-expanding universe. Science calls it the Big Bang. The Bible said what? In the beginning, let there be light. If all matter in the universe is at one point in space and is so dense that you can fit it on the top of a pen, there's no light. Because the gravity's that great, light can't escape it. Bow, you blow it up, gravity becomes less, light can escape, let there be light. So science proves what God said, and the greatest scientist is God. You create this nice little planet called Earth, and you paint yourself in this picture. Just like anybody that draws a picture of a boat on a lake, and you paint yourself sitting on the lake with a fishing pole. Well, God painted himself in and called it mankind. You know why it's called mankind? Same kind as me, only man in the flesh. That's why when Adam said, what should I call all the animals? God said, you me, you little motherfucker. Name them. I gave you everything. You know everything. He said, don't eat from the tree of life and the tree of knowledge. Why? It's called an overdose. If you already got eternal life and eternal knowledge, why would you eat more knowledge and more life? You OD. Baby, what you crying for? They don't want me in a group no more. Boom, boom, I ain't pop locking. My mama said, baby, go dance by yourself. That changed the whole game for me. I sat back and thought about it. I'm like, yeah, shit, I do dance. I don't need four niggas to do that. Second pivotal moment. I got out to L.A. And, you know, when I first got there, I was homeless for 3 months. When you sleep standing up, you learn a lot real quick on what's real and what's fake. That switched the permanent game on I'ma do this, do or die. You understand me? I'm not coming back home. They would ask a nigga like me to come to a golf tennis extravaganza. It's beyond me. I don't play golf. I don't play tennis. Number one. Number two, you hired Eddie Griffin. You didn't hire Bill Cosby. So to walk up to me backstage right before I'm going on, I'm just there to host. Backstage, they asked me and said, the crowd want to see you, Eddie. They want to see you do your thing, bro. You know, give us a show. I said, y'all didn't pay for a show. I got 8 kids, motherfucker. Shit, I slang jokes, not dope. Jokes cost. So now, if you got some joke money, I'll be telling some damn jokes. Other than that, I'm hosting. Earl Graves Jr., they go have a meet me, come back. All right, Ed, you can go on, you can do you. I said, what? Had to check. I said, well, shit, jokes can be told. You can do you. I said, run it by me one more time. You know how I get down. Butt naked truth. I'm going to tell it like I see it. You can do you. Yeah. Because at first they asked me, can you not say the N-word or MF? I said, nigga, you mean motherfucker. All right. Now you can do you. So I go out and do my shit. They turned the mic off for this joke. I said, Kobe Bryant supposedly raped a white woman. Walked. OJ definitely killed a white bitch. Walked. Michael Vick killed a dog. The nigga in jail. I said, the moral to the story must be, keep raping and killing white women. Leave them dogs alone. That's when the mic went off. If they're going to kill the word nigga, then they're going to kill niggas. The Bible says that. First thing the devil has to do before he kills you is kill your name. The reason Obama is still alive right now is because he is still polling in the 60s and 70s. They are laying in the cut. As soon as he is polling in the 30s, they killed his name. Then they can take flight on it. Do you understand it? Right now they scared if they kill him, it's gonna be riots everywhere, which is a fact. If you think we burned down cities over Rodney King's Jerry Curl head ass, fuck with Obama if you want to. Long as he got the people, he's above ground. As soon as he don't have the people, that's a wrap.